Of course, winning the 35th game doesn't mean that that'll be the end. Far from it, because the object is to win 120.
Absolutely.
Again, you want to tell the televiewers what that was all about?
Well, he's trying to get the balls to set where they're all touching each other, and while you can't get them all to touch each other, he does require that most of them are touching. Mm-hmm. And sometimes, especially for a referee that's a little bit inexperienced, perhaps, or not used to playing under the demanding criteria that these top professional players need to perform at a high level, a little nerve sets in, and it's not that easy to move those balls around, especially as the table gets a little... Where? What happens when you tap the balls is it actually dents the cloth, and the balls tend to settle there. So, mm-hmm. And through the course of play, those dents get worn out a little bit. So sometimes you'll see them.
At least at the first to go. Those spots.
Yeah. It's created from friction. You slide your hand over it to make a bridge or something, and it kind of roughs the nap up a bit. Mm-hmm. And then you set the balls up there, they tend to roll apart rather than together.
It's referee, your claim. He gets around a plus.
He's hit a tremendous break, but it looks like he's going to come up a little dry.
Yeah, and he commenced with reclines, so good wreck.
Well, the balls jumped quite well, so he knows that the reason he came up dry was not because the balls weren't racked properly, but because just bad luck set in. And you can see he moved the entire rack to the opposite end of the table, or middle of the table anyway. The score is now 23-21.
Favorite of Earl Strickland.
Efren has come to the table having to face a push-out situation. This is a situation that only occurs right after the break. And that's where an opponent can take one foul, and the incoming player has his option. He may receive the table as it is and play on, or he may pass the table back to the foul-committing player. Earl tried a very difficult shot, and he didn't hit it precisely, but he didn't have position had it gone in either. Yeah. Or it doesn't appear that he certainly wouldn't have had an easy shot on the two. Efren's laying up where he wants the cue ball to go. Looks like he's hoping to have the cue ball go down and bump the two here. Well, you couldn't have drew it on paper any better. Cue ball went exactly where he predetermined it to go. Okay, we got a little skid on the ball there, and if you notice the ball, two ball barely dropped. What happens is sometimes through moisture or friction or a little piece of chalk, we get the ball and it'll hit that and turn just a little bit. Efren fought off the difficulty of a tough shot from a unfortunate position. He's kind of regained control of the table, although the 6-7 did not appear to be an easy situation to negotiate either. 6 and the 7 are on the rail over here by us. Loaded up the cue ball with inside spin to bring the cue ball in between the 6 and 7. And in between it did go. It's kind of an unfortunate situation. If it had it bumped either one of them, he was probably going to come out of that with a reward. Now it looks like he may be confronted with either a combination or a safety play. Chose the combination. And good control on the object ball so that he has another good shot. That was factored into that shot. Extremely well done.
Efren Reyes wins that one. Score now is 23 for Strickland, 22 for Efren Reyes. We'll take a short break. Standing at 23-22 and Earl Strickland and Efren Reyes with the break.
Okay, once again I noticed that the wing ball flew in and the wing ball was on the same side of the rack that the cue ball was on. And that's the ball that they generally try to make. It's either that one or the one on the side. Mm-hmm. The rest of it's purely random. If they find the side of the table that the wing ball tends to go in on real conducively, they will stay to that side of the table. So far in the match, there's not been a side where the wing ball is going in. Efren called the push out. He's taking the foul. And now the option for Earl is a very thin safety, and this is difficult. The idea is to just rock the one in place, only moving the one ball within the parameters of one ball's width from where it's at. And it's a very difficult shot to negotiate. I had very good use of speed. He hit that a little bit heavier than he intended. Forced into a wide open offensive posture. He inadvertently made the three ball. And that's a shot, the very same shot that Strickland made only a little while ago. And that's the shot-making aspect that maybe Earl has a slight edge in. In both instances, extreme difficulty on making that ball. But Earl happens to be pretty handy on those shots. Well, his cue ball speed's got to be perfect because the one ball is pretty close to the pocket. It sure was. Now, Efren does a pretty good job on these type kick shots. I would not be terribly surprised to see a pretty good chance of Efren maybe going to the side cushion on the right-hand side of the table as you look at it and hitting the one ball full and bringing the one ball down on the same side of the table that it's resting on now to the opposite end and try to leave the cue ball on that end of the table. Now, he chose to play offense. Tried to kick the ball in and accept it where the one ball ends up laying at. And that can turn out well as well. Great cut shot by Earl. And he's been a little misfortunate.
The rate that they're playing now, Mark, would you say that the momentum has swung to one player to the other?
Yeah, I would say any of the racks that go more than one turn of the table definitely favor Efren. There's a nice shot. Didn't try to do too much for position because the shot was so demanding he couldn't risk trying to obtain ideal position.
This type of play can't be too greedy.
No, and I think you can see that the toll of the battle here is taking a little toll on the pocketing accuracy of these guys. at that point, once that pocketing is diminished slightly, then tactics become all the more important.
And we're tied up again at 23-all.
For that reason, I think that's why a lot of the onlookers kind of feel that Efren's a virtually invincible force. In the short run, the wide-open offensive guy can get on a streak and just annihilate somebody. But over the long haul, the tactics comes in, and it makes it harder to maintain that high level of offense throughout. And sometimes when you play that high level of offense, you tend to rely a little bit on fortune, too, to cooperate with you in order to generate enough offense.
In a protracted battle, Mark, would you say that one player has the advantage over the other in this situation?
Well, that's what I'm saying. Most of the experts feel that Efren does possess an advantage in that situation. It's yet to be seen, but one thing's for sure, that Efren has never really lost in a protracted battle. So, now we saw a scratch on the break. And
well, the break continues to hound Efren Reyes in this match.
Yeah, you really don't want to carry a lot of turnovers off the break. That's very bad. One thing that's something that Earl doesn't do too often. And you're playing right into his hand if you can give him ball in hand from the break.
Is there a possibility that Efren Reyes is maybe trying too hard on the break?
I don't think he's thinking that. you can see a little less than ideal position off a ball in hand situation. No, he made a great shot, and he is a great shot maker. But you certainly, with ball in hand, try to achieve better position to begin with, so you don't have to be such a tremendous shot maker. Well, clumps of six, but he didn't obtain much of a shot on the four. Looks like he may have to play safe. He's held the safety quite nicely. That was a real nice save. And even if he left Efren a shot, it's going to be difficult to negotiate the six ball to get across the table to the five, which rests on the same rail the cue ball does now. What a shot. What a tremendous shot. Now, you had to use a lot of power on that so that the cue ball hopped off the rail to hit the high side of the six, allowing the cue ball to come to this side of the table. Had he used a softer speed, he would have hit too much of the six, and there was no way to possibly obtain position. Efren, he was a little lucky in that he didn't scratch, but he was a little unlucky in that he didn't obtain a direct route to the five ball. Appears that he's going to have to hook the cue ball or slightly massage around the point on the pocket. He's eyeing that up as we speak.
This he's is not a, taking any chances here.
Well, this is a shot that he's particularly good at, and while I'm not guessing that he's going to make it, I will assure you that he's going to be close.
Yeah, it's more than close.
That's a tremendous shot to get the Q-tip out of the way and hit the ball that hard.
When you get to this level, Mark, is there any possibility that there are situations that come up that you've never seen before?
Well, the balls never lay exactly the same, ever.
Right.
But all these, they've shot at those type shots enough that they, especially at this level, no. I think they handle everything pretty well. Efren got a real fortunate roll there, and you can see the pocketing, the straight-in pocketing is diminished some from the first half of the match. And this is it's a byproduct of the mental strain and stress that eats up a lot of energy, and this it requires so much focus and concentration to play well that you're going to see the pocketing go down. The games will slow down a bit and become a little more tactical.
So it'd certainly be incorrect to say that there is no physical aspect to this game.
Oh, definitely. And training definitely weighs in. Efren's in good shape. I mean, he's very thin and svelte, so that doesn't take a toll. Being overweight would be just brutal to try to play a match of this length. Okay, the ball he's trying to make is the right-handed red three ball. One of them went to the side, rimmed the pocket, stayed out.
So Earl Strickland comes up.
Made a nice opening shot, but it was a thin cut in the side. A little more difficult than it looked.
Well, one thing for sure, Mike, there's never been a dull moment in this match.
No. No, it's definitely been worth the price of airfare.
Oh, yeah. And we're all tied again at 24 by my count.
So it's down to a race to 11 for today's session, and that would be the maximum difference.
Of course, things could turn out differently tomorrow, but at this juncture, it has been a neck and neck race between Earl Strickland and Efren Reyes, as evidenced by the score, which is tied to 24 at the moment.
Okay, the wing ball went in for Earl as well as the nine ball. And
I certainly made short work of that.
Yeah, he's made the wing ball on that side of the table, the four ball that time. Couple times from that side of the table, and now that the nine ball went in, I predicted he's going to break from there again. Sometimes the way the balls settle allow the nine ball to head towards one pocket or another, and when you find a spot where the nine ball starts heading for the pocket, that's the side that you will tend to stay on. Earl now has a one-game lead.
Biggest advantage in this game has been, was it six games?
I believe it was six games.
For Earl Strickland. At the moment, he has a one-game lead over Efren Reyes.
After 50 games of play.
Mm-hmm.
This was with a forecast to be a very close, tight match.
That's what it is.
Well, here's a very nice shot, and this goes to show you the billiards expertise of Efren Reyes. He's positioning both balls on the table, playing the right speed on the object ball as well as the cue ball, in an endeavor to deny his opponent access, easy route to the object ball. Earl made a pretty good kick, but he was a little misfortunate once again. enough for having a ball in hand, Efren didn't get where he wanted to go there at all. And he made a nice shot, and it was a good use of speed that allowed that ball to fall. He caught the rail just a little bit going in, but the soft speed allowed it to hug the rail.
He said the pocketing has not been as accurate as it was early on, but certainly Efren Reyes drawing on his experience here.
Mm-hmm. That was a nice kill shot. That's maximum spin, but minimum force, so the cue ball doesn't slide to the right too much on that little bit of angle that he had. We saw three balls this rack go in with very soft speeds. They had a high volume of power to them. They wouldn't have fell. And that's part of the experience you're talking about. He shoots the ball so that the pocket's conducive to accepting it. And he's taken a very difficult rack and made it look or appear fairly simple.
Efren Reyes ties up the count again at 25. And we've played 50 games, as Mark Wilson pointed out. And none of the crowd here is making a move. They're going to stay on and see what's going to happen here at the end of the evening. This is only the first of three nights of spectacular pool. We're witness to it, seeing these two great players fight it out toe-to-toe. Nine-ball competition, remember? $100,000 pot, winner take all in The Color of Money from Ridgeway's Bar and Restaurant here in Hong Kong.
Okay, Efren set the break. Lost the cue ball again. And he even made an effort to take extra care of the cue ball that time.
Would you say that that's been characteristic of Efren's game, his misfortune at the break?
No, a couple times it was misfortune, but the last few times it hasn't been by virtue of the kiss. It's been slightly mishit. Mm. And I think he may be striving too hard to try to keep up with Strickland's break a little bit, maybe overpowering or overamping. The break has actually worked quite well for Strickland and given him a number of good wins where
sure.
It denied Efren any access to depriving Earl of the win. Looks like a little semblance of rhythm coming back to Earl's game.
Reminiscent of that big run he had earlier on in the match. Earl Strickland with win number 26. First to score 35 wins will end the evening, and then we'll pick it up from there tomorrow. The score will be a carryover or carried over the second night.
And at the end
match.
Of the second night, one of the players is going to be at 70 wins, needing 50 wins in the final night to take the match.
Right.
the trailing player each night actually has an opportunity to win more than prescribed amount, because he can make up the games he's behind from the night before and then actually end up taking the lead. Mm-hmm. Now Strickland's moved out off the rail, which is a nearly scratched. In fact, he did scratch, and he's had such good results off the rail, I don't know why or what possessed him. Maybe he looked at the rack and saw something or felt like it was better from there. But
remember, he held the nine ball from the other side just a few minutes ago.
As well as the wing ball's been flying in over there. Efren made a nice opening shot. You know, it's amazing that even with ball hands, sometimes it's hard. I see players miss balls and have been guilty of doing so myself. Sometimes at home, I practice with my wife, and if she misses one with ball hand, I'll look at her and I say, well, sometimes ball hand's tough, honey. That usually infuriates her.
I can believe that.
Always totally amazed with the proficiency that Efren hits those balls. Just enough speed, just the right spin, the cue ball just gets to the right place. And even all the pool I've ever watched in my life, I can still sit here and my mouth virtually agape of just so awed by his talent. It's like how you see a great artist paint a picture. They just have the exact right touch to each stroke. And
well, the deftness of it really amazes one. This, you're a witness to it here.
This is one talent that I don't know could be trained, and I don't know that you could ever get this. I think this is just a sheer genius and God-given talent. Not that he hasn't worked hard in addition to that, but I don't know if you could ever get this proficient.
We're tied again. Score is 26 all, and this match, which will go to the first player to make 120 games in three nights here at Ridgeways.
You're going to get a good workout on your pool commentating, and you'll be ready for the next match that you encounter, won't you, Ed?
Well, with any luck, maybe with you by my side, I think I'm in good shape.
Yeah, there's going to be some events held in the Philippines. I mean, pro-caliber events that I would imagine that TV will be covering. Okay, Reyes is set to break. The score is tied, 26 apiece. We're going to 35 total wins tonight. I heard a tremendous crash, but I didn't see a ball fly in, and I can look now and see that all the balls are on the table.
Well, there.
Now, it would appear that Earl has a defensive position there, and I think you're going to see maybe some form of a stop shot, moving the one ball the other end of the table and trying to leave the cue ball behind the nine. Yeah, it's right behind the nine.
Right where you said it was going to go.
For once. It looks like we're looking at least a two-rail kick, although I can't tell for sure. Yeah, two-rail kick. And it needed to be struck hard, because when you come off of that rail and then when you contact the one ball, even after contacting the one ball, Efren was going to have to have something hit a rail. And by the time the cue ball hits two cushions, that's diminished a lot of the power out of the cue ball. But when he hit the cue ball so hard, it sunk the rubber in so deep that the cue ball came off a little sharper, a little straighter than what he thought. And that precluded him from making the contact on the one ball, two cushions.
A what's Earl faced with now, Mark?
Well, he's a little off angle. He's all virtually straight into the middle of the end rail with the three, so he's going to require a thin cut. And that magnifies the difficulty of being accurate, but then he also has to be proficient with his position. Just a little bit careless on the previous position shot. He's made an excellent shot. Absolute excellent shot.
Oh, yeah.
Once again, he displays his shot-making skills, and that's what makes for great matches.
Well, we're seeing one here. Score currently tied at 26 all. Once again, Earl Strickland takes the lead at 27-26.
You know, something that Earl does that you don't see hardly any of the tremendous players do is he shoots with ridges that are somewhat unorthodox. And by that, I mean up off his fingertips, not with the base of his hand on the table.
Mm-hmm.
And generally, that's regarded as a little bit unstable. Well, unstable.
Unstable.
It just doesn't guide the tip nearly as accurately. You have to really have a strong bridge. With these players, this quality of play, the tip is aimed at the cue ball in a very specific place, and that tip hits that cue ball within a 16th of an inch. That it has to be that accurate. When you have a fairly crude amateur player, sometimes their tip varies as much as a half inch or beyond, and naturally that hampers accuracy. Okay, Earl's gone to the side break again. He's looking at the three and the one. Three did not go. One did not go. Sign up the seven. That did not go.
I'll leave the table to Efren Reyes now.
Efren has a couple choices here. There's a bank shot past the seven. There's a carom shot under the three, and there's also a safety. He played the carom shot. Can't see exactly what Earl has on the one ball. It doesn't appear that he has a real good shot. He may be able to carom off the one and send the cue ball crashing down to the nine, but that's a risky event. And especially with the cue ball right on the rail, that really denies access to the bottom of the cue ball, and it looks like he needs to get down a little bit lower on the cue ball in order to be able to create the angle that would propel the cue ball solidly into the nine.
To another test here for Earl Strickland.
Oh, this is going to be super difficult to negotiate. If he comes out of this good, it's a testimonial to his immense skills. Play the safe. Wow. Now there was experience for you. He had to roll that ball from the other side of the table 5 feet to make a contact, and then the cue ball barely trickled away, so that took a lot of accuracy as well as a lot of speed control. Efren clearly is at a disadvantage this rack.
Efren's trailing the match 27-26.
He made a tremendous hit on the one ball. That was not easy. That's absolutely as good as you could hope to come out from where he was left. a vast preponderance of players would have committed a foul on that shot. Earl made a very nice cut shot. His bucketing skills are so great that sometimes they're a little bit overlooked because it makes it look so easy and routine. And we've even seen Efren struggle with some of the difficult long shots of almost the exact same shot. Conversely, we've seen Earl struggle with position a little bit more than we've seen Efren.
So therein lies the contrast.
Those balls really hit center of the pocket when Earl sends them pocketward. You can hear him hit the pocket with authority. Another nice shot. He's not going like
this. Straight for corner pocket.
Well, I'm going to tell you, he was pretty unfortunate, and he hit the ball exactly like he wanted to come up short of the side pocket. But because the cloth is still slippery, there was not much grab. By that, I mean the side spin on the cue ball did not grab at all, and it let it lengthen out off that rail. Rarely will you see a scratch on that shot in that corner pocket.
So, Efren Reyes, for once, gets Lady Luck smiling at him in that particular game, and he ties up the game again at 27 all. The rate we're going, Mark, looks like we're going to go for about 230 games.
Yeah. I think it's going to be more than that.
Yeah. Well, he can't get any closer than this match has gone so far. 27 all after 54 games. First to win 35 will wrap it up for this evening to continue and carry the score over tomorrow night here at Ridgeway's.
We've been treated to some tremendous pool, and now you're starting to see the fatigue go set in a little bit. The balls aren't going as freely, and the positions aren't coming as easily. Efren really took something off the break there. He deliberately tried to preclude a scratch on the break.
Sort of let up on that.
Oh, definitely. Shot. Yeah, right. He reduced his power from maybe, say, up around 24 mile an hour down to the 20-21 range. And I think he's a little disappointed with his break tonight. He's been a little unfortunate sometimes, but then overall, he just hasn't performed well in that category. He by no means has a bad break by comparison to the others. It's just that the player he's playing against has such a dynamic one that everybody's would seem pale by comparison.
That has caused him to take some tentative breaks, especially in the latter part of this game, this match.
Beyond that, Earl's won probably six or seven games where Efren didn't even get to come to the table.
Right.
Well, Earl's not happy with the outcome of that shot. Lines up the combination. He's such a pure shooter. He makes that shot look easy, but believe me when I tell you, that's so easy to miss that. The margins of error on combinations are dramatically reduced versus pocketing ball straight in. Yeah, he's truly a picture of confidence when he's out there playing.
Again, he's making a big run here. And looking at him, seems as if he doesn't even ponder it. The shot, just going at it.
Yeah, he definitely doesn't allow himself to talk himself out of a shot. He doesn't suffer from over analysis of a situation.
Well, that can really do you in.
Absolutely. second guessing, because it puts static in your concentration, and in this game it's so difficult. Every shot you need 100% focus on what you're attempting to do. These guys make it look easy, but believe me when I tell you, it takes a toll physically on you to put that type of strain on your mindset to stay focused through shot after shot, day after day, game after game.
Score is 28 for Strickland, 27 for Reyes.
Well, clearly, the separation games is not going to make much of a difference at the end of the day. Mm-hmm. But I know that both these guys would dearly love to have the lead and then kind of have a little feel for the setup that we have here and mentally prepare themselves tomorrow so that they can come out, have a little leeway, work with.
Well, certainly in a three-day match such as this, coming out on top at the first day would certainly be a good psychological advantage,
yeah,
even if it's a small margin.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, if you can suffer through this and gain a little edge, because tomorrow both of these guys are going to play even at a little bit higher level. They're going to have a little better feel of the table under actual play conditions where you have the pressure, the nerves, the stress. They're going to be used to maybe some of the casual mistakes, the few that have occurred. They're going to have those ironed out.
Yeah.
Once again, Efren made a safe that was so strong that just to get to the proper place on the rail, Earl had to curve the cue ball, and he hit it very well, but it's such a difficult shot that even though you hit it well, you might miss it by a fair margin. Efren's maintaining pretty good alignment with the cue ball in relationship to his object balls. Little backspin there.
Well, these guys are not letting up, are they?
Oh, no. No, this is all combat. While that shot looked easy, he obtained a nice angle and he's free of the rail, so he can make an easy position here. Just roll the 8-ball in, let the cue ball come on down table. Direction was natural, so all he had to do was control the speed. Extremely well executed.
This is a familiar refrain, we're tied again.
You notice when Efren took care of the rack that time, all the balls seemed to just go right where they were supposed to. The cue ball just get to the right place on the table each and every time. Soft speeds. And this lends itself to consistency. You don't have to fight with the cue ball. You don't have to muscle it. And the insider's view is that that's what will win this match, is the steadiness of that consistent position. Good, accurate, soft strokes.
Well, Efren has struggled with the break in this match. Let's see how he fares with this one.
Well, I predict he's going to hit a little harder than he did the last break. He wasn't happy with the outcome of that soft break. And he went back to his power. One ball, cornerward. Eight ball froze up on the cue ball, denying him any type of offensive shot. Pretty sure we're going to see a push out. Right now he's electing how he wants to play that push out. The three is very near the pocket. Looks like he's moved the three up by the six. He double kissed it. He certainly didn't mean to double kiss the cue ball. He was trying to hit the three full enough that it would end up by the six, and then even leaving Earl an offensive shot, the three was going to be difficult to deal with. Now that he's made the double kiss, one, he's made the two ball quite a bit easier than he intended, and the three is very makeable. Side of the four ball than what he intended that time, and that was a byproduct of slightly overcutting the three ball. Not happy with the lie of the cue ball on the five. Looks like he's going to have to hit a little hard. Used follow. Extremely well executed. He made that shot look a lot easier than what it is. And time you use topspin, your confidence erodes a little bit because of pool. We only use topspin about a fourth of the time, so you're never as efficient nor confident with that stroke.
Combination there to put the nine ball away and regain the lead. Albeit the one game advantage for Earl Strickland at 29-28. Looking for the player who gets to 35 wins to end the evening, first night of a three-evening affair. The color of money, $100,000 pot, winner take all between these two great players.
I notice Earl's drifted back to his favorite location to break from. Maybe striving to make the four or the one here. He's achieved neither. Good power and good distance on the rack. Look at that. All those balls down there at the end of the table. And as I told you before, it's a one-third failure rate on the break amongst the very best. Anything less than the very best is even a higher degree of failure rate.
Well, I imagine.
Well, the one ball staggered its way in there. Is going to opt to play a combination, left-handed, one leg up in the air. He's executed it flawlessly, but couldn't handle the position in addition to all the other obstacles.
What are his options here now, Mark?
Well, I hate to venture a guess, but it looks like he's going to have to kick at it one rail. He's pretty handy on this. It's a for sure he's going to hit the two. It's just a question of whether he makes it. It's hard to make. He's only going to make it about a third of the time. And he definitely hit it.
Yeah.
And he's the master of kicks. He doesn't miss very many of those. Giving a little commentary here.
Yeah.
Freeing us up to relax.
Well, as they say, different strokes for different folks. And you can't get any more different than the styles of Efren Reyes and Earl Strickland here.
No, he's actually worked with the referees in this match. He's cleaned the table. He's made mention to the promoter, how he feels, and if we put a mic on him, I think he can handle our job too.
Yeah, I know. Well, Mr. Bob Moore just saddled up to us here, and well, everybody's enjoying this match.
Well, it's everything that we were led to believe it would be. Earl can keep his emotions in check here and remain focused. He's got a good chance to take a lead home tonight.
Yes, Mr. Bob Moore on your screens. The proprietor and owner of Ridgeways, which has provided the venue, and an excellent one at that, for this match.
He's a good player himself.
Mm-hmm. I would imagine so.
Yeah.
Strickland has a two-game advantage at 30 games to 28.
It's made a nice save. Stopped the cue ball dead and moved the one ball down to the other end of the table. Not sure if he's totally denied access to the one directly, but for sure he's precluded it from being an offensive situation.
Well, Efren Reyes comes out of his seat with a sheepish grin.
Yeah, he can hit it. He had to play a save. The three ball is difficult, even though the one ball goes by the four. You have to make a tremendous shot, and then I think you have to attempt to either get below the three to play it down table or possibly break them out. Oh boy, what a great shot that was. One of the shots of the day right there. Earl made a tremendous safety that time.
Efren Reyes will have to draw on his immense talent here to try and get a good shot off.
Yeah, unfortunately, this is one that even with immense talent, you mm-hmm. can't do much with. He's going to have to masse to get by the side pocket and create an angle. And as slippery as these rails are, this is a, even for the great Efren Reyes, probably only a 1-in-4 proposition to come out of this with anything positive. He's made a tremendous hit. But, the speed precluded him from doing anything that would maybe have been helpful other than denying ball in hand to Earl Strickland.
Strickland looking to put this game away.
He didn't even take a practice swing on that last ball. He just shot it. Well, he'd be mad if he got straight in and on the rail here. It's going to require an elevated cue shot. One of his patented. Yeah, we made a nice stroke. As you can see, the kid's a shot maker as opposed to the position play. That was the balls were laying out randomly, and Efren probably would have never ended up in that position on the eight ball that the Earl did, but Earl doesn't waste time thinking about position too much. He heads for the right direction and goes, and sometimes it gets away from him a little bit.
He seems pretty confident about his setup and the way he makes his decision, so he doesn't really need that much time. Huh?
Right, and he's immensely confident. He embodies it. But sometimes a little bit overconfident, too. I see him get a little careless sometimes.
So the score now is 31 for Strickland and 28 for Efren Reyes. Strickland needs only to win four more games to end tonight's session, but we'll be back tomorrow to continue on. As we explained earlier, it's going to be a carryover system. Tomorrow, we're going to play for the player to get to 70 wins in preparation for the final night Saturday.
Okay, Earl's back in his favorite place. Up and ready to break. Notice the tremendous follow through he gets on these breaks, Ed. You know, the reason for the tremendous follow through is this. When the cue ball leaves the tip, it's already decelerating because there's no more propelling factor there. So the long follow through allows the tip to remain in contact longer with the cue, and it gives you a little better power. Earl's really got his voice back. He's feeling good. He's feeling confident. He's making balls well again. And seems like he's back in his best rhythm.
That's correct. This is the way he was playing when he established a six-game advantage earlier on. Let's see if he's gotten his second win back.
Well, this kid's a fighter, and I told you, if one thing that may determine this is the will to win, he definitely has that. The eye of the tiger, some call it. I truly feel that his big opponent is not Efren Reyes, but it's going to be himself. It's not impossible for him to self-destruct.
But at this point, he's certainly in the groove. And has taken another four-game advantage at 32-28. We'll pause for these reminders. Score at 32-28 in favor of Earl Strickland.
Earl's coaxing the balls.
Mm-hmm.
Seems to be working pretty well. He's made a ball on the break, one on the side, straight down on two. And this is truly what we talk about when we talk about the Earl Strickland offense. This is exactly what it's all about.
It certainly looks like a juggernaut here.
This is what makes him such a formidable opponent, because he can absolutely deny his opponent access to the table.
Mm-hmm.
And just take the match without you having any say in it.
Well, he's just going right at it.
Got to make a nice shot here. He's got a thin cut in front of him. I don't think it's going to be a difficult one for him. And he made it look easy.
Yeah. He's going for it. Two games away from wrapping up tonight's session, Earl Strickland has a 33-28 advantage over Efren Reyes. And this nine-ball challenge called The Color of Money, $100,000 at stake, winner take all. This match will go on for three nights here at Ridgeways in Hong Kong. I'm Ed Pixon, together with Mark Wilson, bringing the action.
No, he's in a pretty good mood now. He's telling jokes to the crowd, and he's feeling good. When the break starts working for him like that, that's his whole game right there. He needs that to occur. Well, the cue ball got away from him a little bit there. He mentioned it to the crowd and anyone else that would care to hear. Said, I lost the rock. Yeah, he's made a terrific safety. Yeah. He's made a terrific attempt at the safety. It looks like Efren may be able to hit this one ball anyway. Yeah, that was a good shot. Good shot. After you've been sitting there for a pretty good while, yeah. Believe me, that looks like...
He needed that.
Yeah. Looks like you might be shooting a bowling ball with a thimble. Good shot.
The Ray is now down by 4 at 33-29.
The crowd appears to be a little bipartisan here.
Oh, yeah.
Favor, and I think a lot of the fans here really do not know how to take Mr. Earl Strickland. And I'm not saying that his behavior is correct, but whatever, that's what it takes for him to make him play good. You know, he has to get that emotion out. And there's no denying his greatness. The guy can really play. And not only will I tell you, but he will too.
Well, he's been knocking those balls in with a lot of authority. But that last game got away from him.
Well, the shot that he tried to play it safe. And it was a very difficult safe, and he hit it awfully well. Mm-hmm. And came up just a fraction off. I mean, it's, you know, you talk about a lot of games being games of inches. This is a game of millimeters.
Correct.
Now we see something new here. We see a little break with a shot for Efren. Give him a chance to get a little momentum back. And this will be very routine for him. As far as making the match close, this has to be good to give him a chance to get up here and get his arm loosened up a little bit and get back in command of the table again. Feel like you're playing here rather than just watching.
For a moment there, we thought Earl Strickland was up to end the night with just two games left for him, but seems like Efren Reyes has other ideas.
Yeah, he gets to have a little say in that.
So it's down now to a three-game advantage for Earl Strickland at 33-30. Now Efren needs only 5 games to wrap it up. Earl needs 2. But of course, Efren is at the table. Got a good break the last time around.
Referee meticulously inspects the rack. Now Efren prepares to break. We're ready for game 64. He got a little top spin on the cue ball a second consecutive time. And generally that hurts you, but then both times he's come up with some type of a shot.
We've got 2 of the balls in the opposite corner pockets.
Fine, long, straight follow shot. Now he has control of the table. Play the 2 in the side and then the 3 in the corner. I think we may see 2 consecutive breaker runouts in a row for Efren. This is the difference right here. This transition, sometimes Earl's cue ball gets a little bit away from him. He gets too straight in and he has to force the ball around with a good shot. Our Efren is on angle all the time, so the cue ball is naturally traveling in the right direction, and he takes great care. That 4 ball, it seemed very easy. He put some care into that to make sure the cue ball located itself in the proper place. It's not about the shot they're on. It's about achieving the right angle for the 3rd ball down the way is what they're looking at.
Masterful execution there by Efren Reyes, and it's a 2-game match.
Well, this is just
4.
Just incredible, the performance on both players, I tell you.
I tell you. At first, I was incredulous. Now I'm even more than just that. A lot of the people here are up on their feet trying to catch every bit of the action.
I see quite a few smiles on the spectator's face, too, totally amused by the high-level play.
You see Earl Strickland inspecting the scoreboard there.
Earl seems to think that the cue ball's not in a satisfactory place.
Who says it's over the line?
Well, I'll tell you what happens in the rack area, the break area, is that when somebody has a break a lot there, he gets off a warm, and you don't like the break from out of the hole because that sets the cue ball hopping. And when the cue ball's bouncing, then it's much easier to get off the table or into a pocket. It's much harder to control. Plus, it diminishes the amount of power that you get into the rack when there's a bounce to the cue ball, because you're actually driving the one ball downward rather than on a real linear path. Tremendous shot.
Well, as we said, Efren talks back with his cue stick.
He made a tremendous shot, but he had to give up a little bit on position, and now he's going to have to come up with yet another tremendous shot here. Sure, right now when he's chunky, he's weighing out his options of offense or defense. Looks like he's playing offense. Tremendous shot. Absolute tremendous speed and tremendous accuracy. This looks a little reminiscent of the old Efren.
Oh, yes.
And now Efren has taken the page right out of Earl's playbook and come back at him with three consecutive breaker runouts.
Mm-hmm. You can hear the crowd here applaud in appreciation for what Efren Reyes just did. Just a one game advantage here for Earl Strickland. The score stands at 33-32. First player to get to 35 wins will end the session for this evening. The format is we'll carry over the score tonight to tomorrow evening. And on Saturday.
You know, I think this is what's so intriguing about professional pool. Three innings ago, Earl had a nice four or five game lead.
Mm-hmm.
Was coasting and chatting with the audience. And now with virtually no turn at the table, a good turn, the score's back within one game again. One ball went in the side pocket. It's a very difficult shot, but when you've been at the table for a while and are loosened up, that really aids you in making that ball. If you have to get out of your chair cold and shoot that one, the make ratio is not near as high.
But that shot, Efren Reyes may have lost his concentration a bit.
Yeah, he certainly did. And even you can see his body move a little bit on the delivery of the stick, and that move, that tip, that 16th of an inch that I told you can't allow. And it cost him an accuracy. He made quite a few tough shots, and that it's physically draining. You stand there and run three racks, and then you come up with a two ball like he had to cut that in and get a shot. Strickland gets a nice layout to work with.
themselves.
Nicely executed two rail position shot.
Okay, one game away from ending up tonight's session 34-32 in favor of Earl Strickland.
Earl commented to the crowd that the little flurry of racks that Efren put on, mm-hmm. He put some cobwebs on his dick.
Well, those cobwebs certainly didn't make too much of a difference in the way he made it that run.
Trying to engage kind of Efren in conversation. That will not.
Well, Efren's not obliging.
No. He won't be drawn into that game. Mm-hmm. I was loving that. Another tremendous break. That's a tremendous shot. And the reward. Absolute reward. Shot. He's got everything freed up here. It's just a matter of holding your composure. Well, he hits point.
He's certainly going at it now.
A little quee here on the end of this rack. What a tremendous day's play.
Oh, yes. Earl Strickland winning the first night of this three-evening affair called The Color of Money, a nine-ball challenge. So they head back for the pool table again tomorrow with the score standing at 35 for Earl Strickland and 32 for Efren Reyes. And tomorrow, of course, we're going to carry over this score, and another 35 wins will end tomorrow's session, and we go for 120 on Saturday. This has been Ed Picks On with Mark Wilson over here at Ridgeway's Bar and Restaurant in Hong Kong. We'll be back tomorrow. Thank you.
Thank you.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to the Ridgeway's Bar and Restaurant here in Hong Kong. I'm Ed Pixon for Vintage Sports, and with me is Mark Wilson for the second night of the $100,000 showdown between two of the greatest pool players that the world has ever seen. And these are Earl Strickland of the United States of America and Efren Bata Reyes of the Philippines. And Mark, last night, certainly these two players did not disappoint us.
Oh, no, they didn't. And I noticed tonight that Efren has reappeared with a little eye of the tiger. I'm sure he's here to reestablish himself as a foe.
Yes, Earl Strickland won the initial showdown last night to the tune of 35-32. Now, that score will be carried over this evening, and then tomorrow will be the final day wherein the leader will go for 50 more games to wrap it all up.
Yeah, the leader has to obtain 120 rack wins. So we're looking at a good long format, and this gives both players a real fair chance to establish themselves.
Well, we saw for ourselves real pool savvy and a lot of intensity as far as these two players are concerned, and we expect more of the same this evening. So stay with us. We'll have the $100,000 challenge, world nine-ball challenge for you when we come back.
The player's performance yesterday was everything that it we were led to believe. This match was expected to be as both players played their hearts out for us. Could we please show our appreciation with an ample round of applause for both players? Okay, thank you. As most of you know, the score stands at 35 games for Mr. Strickland, 32 games for Mr. Reyes. Tonight's match will conclude when one of these two greats reaches a total of 70 games won. The match will conclude tomorrow night when someone reaches a total game count of 120 wins and will be rewarded with $100,000. But more importantly, he will walk away with the title of the greatest player on earth. Due to the fact that we have close quarters here, please give both of these deserving champions total respect with regards to the physical movement in the room during play, mobile phones, and appreciative applause for good shots and games. And now the players. Any place in the world that you go to play pool, you only have to mention the name Efren and Earl, and the people there know who you're talking about. Please welcome from Angeles City, Philippines, Mr. Efren Reyes. And from Greensboro, North Carolina, Mr. Earl Strickland. Let's rack the balls.
Here we go.
Resumption of the $100,000 challenge winner take all in nine ball. As we mentioned at the opening of this particular segment, Earl Strickland leads the match 35 games to 32. And tonight we'll wrap it up as soon as one of the players reaches 70 games won. Another good break by Earl here, Mark.
Yeah, he's opened the rack nicely, and he just now looked at the five to make sure that it passed by the six, and it appeared that he was happy with the way it was laying, so a real good chance for him to score the draw first blood here.
Well, we can see that Earl Strickland has come out of the gates on fire, as it were. This is the type of movement that we saw last night. Whenever Earl was on a run, it would be very decisive and very quick with his decisions.
Well, he lashed out with a couple major flurries within that, mm-hmm. and Efren seemed to withstand the punishment and even delivered a couple of his own.
Well, it was as close as it could get the first match yesterday. Ooh. What happened there?
Well, not an easy shot, and it was deceptive because he had to cut it thin and make mm-hmm. the speed proper to get the angle on the nine.
Well, we were saying that Efren Batarez had several runs of his own, and he held his own against Earl Strickland yesterday. As a matter of fact, he even gained the lead several times during the match. But Strickland beat him to it. Actually, towards the end, Earl Strickland had a five-game edge, which Efren was able to narrow down to only one.
Yeah, and he had a chance to bring the match 34-33, mm-hmm. and he missed a shot. It was a difficult right. shot, but he did miss a ball that would have made drawn the match that much closer.
Well, Efren wins the first game. And he gets the one ball in the side pocket.
And I certainly think that's going to be what's going to tell the tale for Efren tonight, if he can come off the break with a little better results than what he had last night.
Well, certainly a lot to be desired as far as that department was concerned last night for Efren Reyes.
Well, to make matters worse with that department, it's something that's a little bit out of your own control as mm-hmm. well. Now, he's chosen a role out here. That's where he takes a foul. And the incoming player has a choice, an option, to either accept the shot and play from there or give it back. Earl's going to play the kick shot. Tremendous shot.
Remarkable shot by Earl Strickland. Plus, he said it's one of his fortes. Set himself up very beautifully.
But this kid from Greensboro, North Carolina, can really play.
Oh, yes. Well, the crowd here at Ridgeway's has certainly given these two gentlemen a lot of respect, especially after what he saw last night.
Nicely executed.
And
we're blessed with a very knowledgeable crowd here,
yeah.
too. I think you can kind of look around and see people from all walks of life and a lot of the upper class.
Well, this is a by invitation only affair. And, well, Mr. Bob Moore, the proprietor of Ridgeway's Bar and Restaurant, has certainly seen to it that the people who come here know and appreciate the sport.
Well, the score now stands at 36 for Strickland and 33 for Reyes. We're about ready to witness Strickland's patented break. Didn't hit him with the same dynamic effect he has in some of his breaks in the past.
Got the eight ball in the side pocket with some body English on the part of Earl Strickland there.
And he's getting a pretty good shot off the break. This was something that haunted him a little bit last night. Mm-hmm. He just wasn't having very good fortunes off the break. But nonetheless, still managed to squeak out the six or eight break and run out racks.
Well, certainly he had a better time of it than Efren.
Right away, he's found his good pace, and that mm-hmm. Does not bode well for Mr. Reyes.
Well, he's striding very confidently, and his shot-making is just superb at this juncture. Earl Strickland posts a four-game advantage at 37-33. But we've seen from what we saw last night, we know that Efren Reyes does not get worried about such a lead, because he can always come up with some of his own flurries and just make it a lot more exciting.
Well, that's right. And a few games between these two players is virtually no safe lead at all. Mm-hmm. So Efren knows at any one moment he could actually lash out and tie the match or even take the lead without Earl even having benefit of another turn of the table. And we started off with a very swift pace to this match.
Yeah. It'll
be interesting to see how long they can maintain that.
But there was some discussion last night about how Efren plays the cue ball and on the table.
Well, upon further inspection, the wear area where a player would set the cue ball has become pitted, and mm-hmm. the cue ball will not settle under the legal definition of where you must break from.
It rolls down to.
So the players have to work a little harder to place their opening shot. And I believe Earl's got a pretty good shot at carrying the nine ball in for a game-winning shot.
That's what he's looking at. Yep. It is now a five-game lead by Earl Strickland over Efren Reyes at 38-33. Break, I bet that break.
That's two consecutive break and runouts for Earl, so he's well on his way.
Earl Strickland leads it 38 games to 33. Efren Reyes has only been able to get to the table once in tonight's session.
And certainly at this pace, our night's work will be done quite early.
Certainly looks that way.
What a dynamic break.
Just as he wanted it.
That was his good break. One, he creates unbelievable power, but then maintains that accuracy with the cue ball. So mm-hmm. the cue ball doesn't fly off the table or run around the table. And this only comes with hours and hours of practice on a daily basis. You cannot maintain that high degree of timing that's required to do that with anything less.
You can see the precision that these players display. You know that a lot of hard work was put in.
Speed on that. He's achieved an ideal angle to transfer the cue ball better into the table. And while you cannot take shots for granted, it's looking like an imminent third break and run out in a row for Mr. Strickland.
He's starting out like a house on fire, as we always say. Come out real smoky here on the second night of the World Nine Ball Challenge here at the Ridgeway's Bar and Restaurant in Hong Kong. He now leads by six games over Efren Reyes at 39-33. The only time that Efren was able to come up to the table was when Strickland missed a shot and Efren only had to hold out two more balls. And
Well, they call Earl the million-dollar man, mm-hmm. and the reason is that they had an insurance policy at the tournament that dared anyone to run from the break 10 consecutive games.
Mm-hmm.
Well, Earl accomplished that, and that's how he became the million-dollar man. And I think he's kind of showing you how he was able to do it.
Earl tells referee Neil Martin to check the position of this cue ball.
Well, another thunderous break, and that nine ball's heading for the corner pocket time and again, if you notice it's ending in the same place.
And does he have a shot at the nine ball in this particular?
It looks like he may. I can't tell from this angle. If he feels confident with the cut on the two ball, I think he's just going to play the two straight away.
Yeah, rather than risk a shot that would be a carom, he chose a little bit safer route. And then he felt like if he could get a pretty good shot off the two ball, then he would go ahead and continue to finish up the game. Seeing some vintage Earl Strickland pool right now. Tremendous draw stroke to obtain position on the six. Nice drawing it back for the seven. He's a little concerned with the side pocket coming into play here. If you elevate and use backspin, it makes the pocketing of the seven ball more difficult.
Uh-huh.
And if you choose to not, then you have to run the risk of possibly scratching in the side. So he's elevated. And made it look awful easy.
Goes for the combination to put his 40th game away. And as we said, Earl Strickland has come out smoking, and the second night of the Color of Money is what this affair is called. A $100,000 pot at stake, winner take all. And this is a race to 120, actually, over three nights here at the Ridgeways Bar and Restaurant in Hong Kong. This is the biggest lead, I believe, that we've ever had in this tournament, this competition. Seven game lead by Earl Strickland over Efren Reyes.
Looks like Earl's gonna keep score himself here to make sure we're doing our job properly.
Now there you see the logo of the venue of this one-of-a-kind match between Earl Strickland of the United States and Efren Reyes of the Philippines.
Strickland's on a four consecutive break and run out of time. And he'd won one game previous to that to get to that point. And he hammered the break once again, but he wasn't the beneficiary of a ball dropping.
Well, he almost got the one ball in the corner pocket, but just didn't roll a couple of centimeters more.
Well, Efren opened up with a nice shot. It was a little more difficult than what met the eye, even though the one ball was there to get the cue ball in the proper alignment for the two. It took a little doing.
As he said last night, the finesse that Efren shows on the pool table is just unbelievable.
What a nice position shot that was. Perfect execution in the three rail position. To this point in the match, I don't believe Efren's missed a shot. He won the first game of the evening. Broke, made a ball on the break, and was forced to push out. Earl kicked that ball in, and then broke and ran out four racks after that.
Right.
Nice speed. Efren obtained just a little bit of straight angle on the eight so that he could just stop the cue ball rather than obtain perfect position.
Well, he wins his second game of the evening, cuts the lead of Earl Strickland to six at 40-34.
So each player, we've yet to complete each player's second turn, and we've already had seven games elapse.
good break by Efren and set up nicely for the two ball.
Well, he's not really. He's awfully straight on this. He can make the two, but obtaining the ideal position on the three does not look readily available. And the chance for a scratch, he could possibly foul this ball in. It's very difficult to use backspin because the cue ball is located on the cushion. Yeah, he hit it pretty good, but pocket just wouldn't hold it. Oh, very nice shot, executed by Earl. He was able to maintain pretty good cue ball control.
It sidled up to the eight ball.
Now I'm sitting for once in the proper area. It looks like it would be makeable. He's scrutinizing it closer than I am. Going rail first, so apparently it wasn't measurable. What a spectacular rail first shot that was. Now this kid's absolutely on fire.
Oh yes. Sizzling start here by Earl Strickland. He posted a 7-game lead earlier, but Efren Reyes was able to take a game. So that's down to 6 now, 40-34. But Earl's on a run again.
And that was one of those elevated cue shots that I had made mention of earlier that are his absolute specialty. Back into his two-stroke rhythm. It's lights out for these balls.
No problem there. Back to a 7-game advantage for Earl Strickland at 41-34. Rick Abbott, we don't have to talk anymore in between games because they're gonna splice it up anyway. It's just too long.
Yeah, right.
Does this particular format been done before, 35-35?
No, it was only for this one event, just so that we could get a real long enough test that both players could get a chance to get acclimated to the table, comfortable. Yeah, Earl come out with another flurry. This is about the third major flurry, you know, because he won this game and then four more with it. That's pretty devastating. In Efren's behalf, the two ball that he had to shoot at last game was just murder to have to make that shot.
Score stands at 41 games for Earl Strickland and 34 for Efren Reyes. This is the second of a three-night affair in the Color of Money. That's what it's called, a $100,000 challenge, winner-take-all, between two of the greatest players that the pool world has ever seen.
Got to negotiate some balls, and he's eyeing it up. This will be an incredible shot. It's an off-angle combination shot he's looking at. Plus, he's got to negotiate through three balls to get to it. Well, he was able to avoid the combination. I didn't see that shot as even available.
win the shot.
Earl Strickland now showing the controlled side of his game.
And he's worried about the cue ball being impeded by the eighth ball. And if you notice, his balls are going right in the middle of the pocket. Even mm-hmm. on the difficult shots, he's having absolutely no trouble finding the pocket.
Well, I was talking to Efren Reyes after the match last night, and he had real nice words about the pocketing of Earl Strickland. He says he's one of the best.
Yeah, he has an uncanny accuracy, and no matter how much you practice, I'm not sure that could be learned.
Earl Strickland is not letting up on his very aggressive play tonight. Score is 42-34. Okay. Score stands at 42 for Strickland, 34 for Efren Reyes.
Well, we've played 9 games tonight, and of those 9 games, Earl Strickland has broken around the entire table 5 times. Now, that's a level of 9 ball that we've never seen, and it's been happening consistently throughout these last couple days. Now, Efren approaches the table after Strickland's finally come up dry on the break. That might be the first time tonight. Well, the crowd applauding a push out. They saw the 9 ball go in and thought it was a legal shot.
Well, Earl passes it back to Efren.
Not a very palatable situation to have to approach the table with. Sit there for a long time. Earl's got a shot at the 1, but this requires a little negotiating to get the proper position. Yeah, made it look effortless. That's only the second ball that we've seen Earl miss tonight, I believe.
That's true.
Hey, Efren's trailing by 8 games, and that's not really the significant part of it. He needs to get a couple good starts here. 8 games is not an insurmountable lead at all.
Not at this level of play.
Not at all, but he really needs to kind of get established here and get in the match. Through no fault of his own, he's trailing. The other players just played so well. Unlike in other sports, in this sport, you may not get some good starts for a good long while when the players are playing at such a high level and luck is not playing a role for you either.
Well, especially if you don't get a turn at the table.
Exactly.
Because the other one's playing that well.
And that's what's unique to this sport. And I think that adds a certain level of intrigue or mystery as to
It's compelling drama.
Well, there's a certainly high drama, because I can imagine what sort of desperation seeps into your mind when you're just sitting there watching the guy do his thing.
Yeah, just like when Efren retaliated last night with 4 or 5 wrap rounds. Mm-hmm. Earl said, hey, there's cobwebs on my cue. Well, absolutely no one doubts Efren Reyes' supremacy at location.
Well, Efren Reyes wins his third game of the evening and cuts the lead down to 42-35.
That break. Look at the cue ball stopped dead. The 8-ball sifted into the back pocket. And unfortunately, I believe the 3-ball may have impeded the 1-ball's access to the corner pocket. If that's the case, we will not see him play a combination shot, I don't believe. Look at this masterful safety.
Just hid that cue ball behind the 3.
The speed and the control that was required, that's harder than making most shots. And the knowledgeable audience here acknowledged that.
With a lot of oohs and ahs.
Well, that fine safety was rewarded now. Efren is going to get to start this game with ball in hand. That's the penalty for a foul in 9-ball pool. Now, statistically speaking, with players of this skill, when you award your opponent ball in hand, it's an 85% to 90% immediate loss. So it's just near death to commit a foul.
Why does it happen that way, Earl, that when you give your opponent ball in hand, he's most likely to make it?
Well, because he gets to start with such a good position, and once these guys establish control of the table, and especially the masterful Efren Reyes position play, he very seldom has to make a great shot after he starts with ball in hand. Now he's obtained pretty straight in angle on the 5, and he's going to have to force it just a little bit. And this was probably the best he could have did under the circumstances, but less than what you would like to have. He hit that ball awful nice. You had to use quite a bit of speed, and when you go down the rail at that speed, the pocket's very unforgiving.
Mm-hmm. It's as if the pocket shrinks, huh?
Absolutely. When the ball comes at it with speed, the pocket size diminishes.
Well, 2 games in a row. This is the first time that Efren's been able to manage it tonight. And the score is 42-37. I'm sorry. Correction, there it's 42-36. In favor of Earl Strickland. When one of the players reaches 70 games won, then we will retire tonight's session to come back tomorrow.
Well, you maneuvered the cue ball around the 6 quite nicely there. One of the things that the viewers at home might enjoy watching is if you notice how loose Efren grips the pool cue. This allows him to obtain a high volume of spin on the ball with a minimum amount of force. And he can achieve shots that the other players don't even imagine. Their strokes aren't capable of affecting the cue ball in the same way. The ultralight grip, what it does is it allows just 19 ounces of cue to strike the cue ball as opposed to 19 ounces plus 10 foot-pounds of muscle pressure. And when you get that extra weight hitting that, it doesn't apply spin. It just slides the ball out there.
What sort of advantage does spin give a player?
Okay, what it allows him to do is utilize, it makes the pockets much more forgiving because he can use minimum speeds but travel the cue ball great distances because it retains so much spin so freely. So he pockets balls a little freer and he's able to do more dynamic things with the cue ball.
It is now 42, Strickland, 37, Reyes.
Interestingly enough, that's Efren's first break and run out of the evening. Well, these guys are both warriors, and I'm sure that it's going to be very exciting throughout the evening.
Well, it has been throughout this match. First night, we ended the session with Strickland in the lead at 35-32. Score now stands at 42 games for Strickland and 37 for Reyes.
Oh, that flash of the old Efren there. He opened this rack with a tremendous shot on the one ball. Now it's just a matter of maintaining his focus through the rest of the balls there. They're aligned properly. He seems to be pocketing balls a little freer than he was earlier in the match, where he's kind of established the rhythm and the tempo now. You know, in addition to the great shooting we're seeing, able to compose yourself when you're trailing in a match like this, with your opponent playing so well where it just looks like you have no chance. This is really where the experience comes in. And this is what makes this a sport.
Well, I guess for mere mortals, the temptation to try and hurry it up would just be too great.
You're absolutely right.
Score is 42 for Strickland, 38 for Efren Reyes.
As you were saying before, the temptation to hurry up is definitely great. It has to be fought. You're not going to win a bunch of games in a row with one stroke of the cue. You have to make a ball at a time. And it's hard to maintain that level of tempo that makes you stay focused shot after shot, ball after ball. But that's what's necessary.
Then you'll be fighting against human nature. But that's what makes great players, right?
More importantly, I think that's what makes this such an interesting thing to watch when you're aware of all the different subtleties that go into the sport. Now, Efren's confronted with another difficult ball to pocket. If he makes it, the reward's fairly great. Taking the moment to compose himself. Make sure he gives himself a real good delivery with the tip through the cue ball. One of the few times that we've seen him where he really actually took a moment to. He's hitting the pocket nicely now. You ahead and use some power on that. That demands accuracy. Made it look effortless. I'm here to tell you, it's very difficult.
Mm-hmm.
If it was any easier, I'd be out there doing it myself.
Well, the crew was telling me that you showed them a thing or two about pool earlier. All right, Efren Reyes coming back with a flurry of his own with five straight games to narrow the gap to just three games, 42-39.
Interesting enough, that's Efren's third consecutive break and run out.
Mm-hmm. But the score standing at 42 for Strickland, 39 for Reyes. Efren now with the break. Again, he doesn't get the good fortune of holding out any of the balls, and that brings up Strickland after a five-game run by Efren Reyes.
Strickland opened with a nice shot. He wasn't rewarded with ideal position, but he has a makeable ball. He seems to have a good composure tonight as well.
Yes.
Staying real focused on the match. What a tremendous shot that was. Sometimes in the past, he's had to not only defeat his opponent, but it's some of the inner demons that seem to haunt him or plague him through the years.
Well, we were witness last night of some display of temper by Earl Strickland, but that didn't seem to affect his game too much. On the contrary, he won last night's session 35-32.
Well, he's cruised through this rack effortlessly after pocketing the two ball. He had to open the rack with two tough shots, and then after that, he gained control of the table and went through the rack easily.
And it is back to a four-game lead by Earl Strickland, 42 for Strickland, 39 for Reyes.
Now we can see another tremendous break shot.
Beautiful break there by Earl Strickland.
And this is really power pool at its best.
Mm-hmm.
When it's on, it's a beautiful thing. Enables you to accrue quite a few games in short order.
Which is what he did at the start of this session. Opened up an eight-game lead at 42-34. Efren had his moments and cut it down to 42-39 until Earl won the last game to make it 43-39.
Well, Earl's confronted with a power shot, and not an easy one. I don't think the 8 ball impedes the swing, but he's going to have to muscle up a little bit on this ball. A shot that's very missable for mortals, but players of this talent seem to cruise right through those. Yet another break and run out for Earl Strickland.
So it's now 44 for Strickland, 39 for Reyes. The score is 44 for Strickland, 39 for Reyes.
Well, Strickland made a nice break, but the cue ball got away just a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
He's in a push-out position now. That means he's going to take a foul and try to maneuver the cue ball to a little better place on the table. He's declared push. Efren will now come to the table with an option. The option to accept the table as it is or force Earl to play from here.
One is not obliged to call out the push.
Well, actually it is, but if it's an obvious situation, then we know what's intended. Chose a safety. Not sure if he's not happy with it at all. The one ball hit the point. I can see on the monitor that Earl has a makeable shot. Right now, Efren just not getting the benefit of much of the good fortunes. And I don't mean to say that Earl is getting a lot of good fortune. He's created his own luck.
Mm-hmm.
But Efren really, even though he had a little flurry in there, has yet to really look like he's super comfortable out there. I guess it would be kind of hard to feel real comfortable when your opponent doesn't miss a ball.
Yeah.
Racks and racks on end. You know, part of what's creating the high-level play is that the playing conditions in this place are absolutely impeccable. The table's playing great. The cloth is new. The balls are clean. These are all important factors in being able to maintain a high-level play.
Not to mention the crowd, of course, that certainly has been behaving very nicely so that no distractions are there for the players.
Looks like Earl's going to cruise through yet another rack.
Yes. It is now 45 for Strickland, 39 for Efren Reyes. 6-game lead.
On the screen in the background, I think we can see Mr. Puyat.
Yes, Mr. Puyat just came in. Just flew in actually from the Philippines. and that should boost the morale of Efren Reyes. His benefactor is on hand together with son Joey, of course, beside Mr. Puyat. Earlier you saw Mr. Bob Moore of Ridgeways.
And really, the sport of pool owes Mr. Bob Moore a debt of gratitude. And I mean players past, present, and future all do for attempting to bring pool into the forefront of all sport.
Well, I believe this is this particular match is a concept conceptualized by Mr. Moore. And he has given it all-out support.
Well, the TV people that he acquired are absolutely fantastic to work with.
Well, thank you very much. He also provided us with a great commentator and analyst in the person of Mr. Mark Wilson here.
Well, that was nice of you to say that. I had you said it just like I wrote it earlier.
Meantime, Earl Strickland goes about this particular game as if it was all in the script that he wrote. Picking up win number 46 to 39 of Efren Reyes.
9:30.
Tell us again, Mark, is there any particular order as far as the balls are concerned when they rack them up?
Well, we try to maintain fairness by putting the balls in the same numerical sequence in the rack. And that, so the one goes on the front and the two in the back. The three and the four are on the wings, the exterior of the rack. Mm-hmm. And the rest of them is random, but those are the ones that are the most important. And that way it's uniform for both players so that they have the best chance of obtaining a shot from the break. Well, in the United States, when somebody plays like this, we call it dead stroke, which means he's just making ball after ball with no problem. Hard ones, easy ones alike. And Earl came out of the gate on the dead run.
Well, he's hardly made any mistake tonight. Maybe one or two minor ones that gave Efren Reyes an opportunity a couple of times. But Efren so far has not been able to sustain that. Although he did have a five-game run earlier.
Well, as the score stands right now, Earl has broken run out seven times tonight, and Efren's only broken run out three. And discounting those games, Efren's actually made up a game on the score from last night. So it kind of bears out what we said about what each player needs to do to win, is that Efren needs to get into a game where there's shooting in each rack for both players. That's where his strength lies. And conversely, Earl needs to play the break and run out game.
Score is now 47-39. score is 47 Strickland, 39 Reyes, and Strickland again for the break.
Tremendous follow through extension on the break. And I believe Earl's come up dry on this break.
Yes. That brings up Efren Reyes again. After cooling his heels for quite a while there. As Earl won five straight games.
Efren obtained a bit of good fortune there, but he played a smart shot. The cue ball was on this end rail, and it was unlikely that he was going to leave much with it, so he could be a little more aggressive on that shot. See the nice draw stroke. Now this shot is a little tricky because the 3 and 9 are not aligned perfectly for the pocket, so you have to manage the 3 ball into the 9 properly in order to get it to go.
You got it. 47 to 40 in favor of Earl Strickland.
It certainly doesn't take him long to clip off a bunch of games, does it?